So last week we announced updates to all of Lightroom's surfaces. In fact, my previous video covers all of the improvements to Lightroom Desktop, and I'll leave a link to that at the end of this video in case you missed it. However, there was an update to Adobe Camera Raw that includes a new feature that's so ridiculously cool and further illustrates the practical benefits of AI for photographers that I wanted to cover it in its own video. Now, my testament to the practicality of this new tool is that I didn't have any images in my library to test it with because I go to great lengths to avoid it. And if I can't, I just don't take the photo. Thankfully, Katrine Eisman, my friend and colleague on the Lightroom team, was gracious enough to share some of her own photos so that I can show you how this new feature works. The feature I'm talking about is called Reflection Removal, and it's available right now as a technology preview in Adobe Camera Raw, which you can access from Photoshop or Bridge. And you don't even need to install Photoshop Beta. Reflection Removal is available right within the public GM version that you can download from the Creative Cloud desktop app. And for all of you Lightroom users out there, I'm excited to share that Reflection Removal will be coming to Lightroom in the future. All right, let's dive in. All right, so before we jump in, there are two quick things I want to show you. The first is, here is my friend Katrine Eisman, who I just mentioned. The photos that I'm going to show you in this video are hers, and I'm very grateful. But even cooler is she was in New York City with Stephen Bologlu, who is the director of product marketing right behind her, to receive the award by Apple for Mac App of the Year. Lightroom was announced as the winner last week, and this is just so cool. So I just wanted to share that. I just love this photo. But also, speaking of reflection removal, whenever we release usually a major feature, generally there will be a blog post that goes with it. And I highly recommend that you don't skip over this one for reflection removal, because oftentimes you're not only just going to get an idea of how the tool was built, but more of a context of why the tool was built and things that you should do to maximize your success when using reflection removal. So I'll leave a link to this in the description below. Again, tons of really great information, great examples, and it'll tell you how this works. Now, I stopped right here intentionally because one of the things I want to show you very clearly is currently reflection removal will only work with RAW files. So if you have, you know, Sony RAW files or even Apple Pro RAW files, that will work. But for now, JPEGs and TIFFs and those other file formats, those won't work with reflection removal yet. So just be sure that you are feeding the right kind of photo if you want to check it out. All right, now let me show you how this works. First, like I mentioned, you're going to want to make sure that you have the latest version of Photoshop installed. So launch the Creative Cloud desktop app. You can click on apps over here and then click on check for updates. And you'll want to make sure that you have the latest version. I'll close out here and let's bring up Photoshop. So I've got three images to show you. And once again, these are photos that were provided to me by my friend and colleague, Katrine Eisman. She owns these photos. So the common thing with these three photos, if I kind of go through them really quickly, as you can see, is they have reflections. And I mentioned this in the intro, I would not normally take these photos. I just wouldn't. If I had to, though, I would probably try to put my phone against the glass if I could, just to reduce the reflection. But for the most part, oftentimes, even when I'm on an airplane, if I'm flying somewhere, it's just usually kind of difficult to get a good photo because there's all of this light reflecting in the window of the plane. But this is where reflection removal honestly is just so amazing. All right, so what I'm gonna do is open this up in Camera Raw. I open these images in Photoshop as smart objects. You can see they're smart objects because of this little icon on the bottom right of the layer thumbnail. So I'm just gonna double click here and you can see we are in Camera Raw 17.1. This is the version of Camera Raw that you need if you want to use reflection removal. Before you do anything though, the first thing you'll want to do now is click on the gear icon on the top right, which are your preferences. Click on technology previews on the left here and make sure that this checkbox for new AI features and settings panel is enabled. You'll have to restart Photoshop if this has been deselected. So select it, click OK, restart Photoshop and open your image up in Camera Raw. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'm just going to crop in a little bit and just, you don't have to. I'm just going to bring it in kind of like this and up like that. Cool. Now, to get to reflection removal, you're going to want to click on the remove icon on the right toolbar over here. And you'll see under distraction removal, there is a checkbox here called reflections. And so all you need to do is click on it and you'll see that it will start processing. And then there you go. I mean, I don't even know what to say. I honestly don't know what to say, how ridiculously cool this is. So reflection removal will present you with a slider, and the value of the slider goes from 100 to negative 100. You would think maybe it would go from 0 to 100, but this is the thing that I love about our data scientists when they build these new features, is they don't just kind of do the most obvious thing, but they think truly outside the box. So you can see, when you enable reflections, it'll be brought up to 100, and this is basically full reflection removal. Now watch, as I bring this towards 0, you start to see the reflection being restored into the image. So this was, at 0, was the image that Katrine took. But watch what happens when we go to negative 100. It goes the opposite way. And there is Katrine holding her iPhone, taking the photo on the corner here in New York City, on Broadway. And I mean, going back and forth, you have two distinct images. And that's something that, you know, it's really important to think about when you're thinking about reflection removal. And they will explain this in the blog post that I referenced, but there are two images when you're thinking about a photo with a reflection. There is the image of the subject that is through the pane of glass, the photo that you want to take. But of course, there's also the photo of the reflective image. So you have, of course, light coming through glass, and depending on the angle that you're taking it in, you could see another image. You can see the image of yourself in the reflection. And so here at negative 100, that's what the AI model is attempting to do, is to show you kind of the other side of things. So more likely than not, you're going to want something like this. And then of course, you can see there are a few little specular highlights here. I have noticed that is currently one of the things that you'll have to look out for, where the AI model tries hard to do, but sometimes doesn't always work out perfectly, is if you have, you know, bright specular highlights or bright light sources, that sometimes will be difficult to remove. So fortunately, I mean, we have generative AI. So all I need to do here is just kind of make a selection on these little spots here and then click on remove, and they're gone. And so now I can click on okay and then use all of Photoshop's tools. All right, let's move on to this second image. Again, the primary purpose of this video is not to edit the photos, but to kind of show you reflection removal. So once again, I've got this smart object. I'm going to double click and open it up in Camera Raw. Let's go ahead and click on crop and click on auto to fix the geometry a bit. So that does a nice job there. And then let's go to remove. Now, you don't need to crop first. I'm just doing that just because it's my own OCD thing where I like to crop and adjust the geometry if it needs it. You can go to reflection removal right away if you want, just to see if it's an image you'll want to edit. But I just wanted to point that out. So again, clicked on remove, and then let's click on reflections. And then I don't have words. I am just truly amazed at what this just did. Because again, if we bring this back, look at zero, basically. Look at, this is the image that Katrine took. And then at 100, those reflections are gone. And so you have an image that you can actually work with without having to deal with a lot of those reflections. Of course, again, you can use Gen Remove to get rid of these little specular highlights and stuff like that. And then also don't forget that we can take this to negative 100. And there is Katrine taking her photo, which again is just so, so cool. So there you go. Let's go ahead and click on OK. And actually just one point to bring out about smart objects, one of the benefits of it is I can always double click now, go to reflection removal again, and let's say I want a little bit of it, of that reflection. I just want a little bit of presence there. I can adjust it on the fly and then click OK. And again, Smart Objects retains those settings. All right, let's go to this third and final photo that Katrine took through a window, obviously. And so again, beautiful light here, but you can see it's probably really cold. Maybe she didn't want to go outside and freeze, so she decided to take the photo through this glass. So let's go ahead and double click here. Let's click on remove, and then let's enable reflections. And then, I mean, there you go. This is just bonkers amazing. Absolutely amazing. Because you can click on the eye icon here to see what the image looked like without any reflection removal. And just to see this here and what you're able to do with this new tool. Again, though, we can go to negative 100 and you can see the reverse here. But to me, the real winner is this. I mean, this to me is always going to be just amazing. And so again, that is why I think this tool is just truly revolutionary. I mean, now when I see a photo and there's a little bit of a reflection in it, I'm just going to take the photo because I know I can more likely than not get rid of the reflection and edit it as I see fit. Now, I mentioned that I have this video here. If you want to check out all of the updates to Lightroom Desktop, it's got everything that you'd want to know. And if you found this video helpful, a thumbs up is always appreciated. And be sure to click on the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot.